Hello, it's 10 o'clock, August 3rd. Welcome to the weather update. And another beautiful day. A bit more clouds than yesterday, but still very comfortable out. Very, very nice day across the area. And yes, I did go to see some pines again as well. There's the proof. The sky, we had a lot of these cumulus and stratocumulus clouds in the sky. But all in all, another pretty nice day out there. It's a little cloudier than yesterday, but other than that, still another nice day that we had. Let's take a look at our current conditions. You can see the cloud cover, and then it's kind of like diminishing as the day goes on. Let's look at the MODIS satellite as well. So you get to see here, see a lot of this. This was in the morning before all the clouds popped up, and then we had a lot more clouds pop up later on in the day. But other than that, really not. Nothing really that, maybe it was mostly cloudy at times, but there was still a good amount of blue sky out there. It was a very nice day. And let's go now to our current conditions outside right now. And we are down into the 60s already. Look at that, 63 in Carl Place. Unfortunately, in the alley, it's still 69. I was finally able to turn off the air conditioner last night and this morning. And I figured, let me just leave it off most of the day. Come back, it's 77 degrees in the air, even though I got the window open and a fan blowing out of it, just because it's just so, you know, this place just gets so hot, so I had to put the AC back on, which is ridiculous, but that's what it is when you don't have cross ventilation and your windows face an alley. And I just hate putting the air conditioner on when you don't have to. Most people don't have to put it on, but for me, I have to, unfortunately, have it on. You can see here, until it cools off a little later, you'll see temperatures generally. Look at this. We even have some upper 50s on the North Shore. Look at those nice low dew points there across the area. 64 and 55 at Islip, 64. 64 with a dew point of 55 at Islip, 64 with a dew point of 54 at Farmingdale. West Hampton, 54, dropping pretty quick in West Hampton. They're going to go into the 40s. They were in the 40s last night. We're going to look at the lows, too. 52 was your low. 52 was the dew point. Of course, the city holding in the heat. It's very much my alley is like the city. It holds in the heat. That's why it's still 72 at LaGuardia, 67 at Central Park, 68 at JFK. Still got north to northwest winds. Let's see what it is in Jersey. 61 in downtown Toms River. A little more humid there. Dew point up to 58. 60 at Lakehurst with a dew point of 57. Let's go look at at our highs and lows for the day. We'll start off with the lows first. So we'll do the low temperature first. And you'll see last night, Carl Place got down at 53. Not bad, 57 in. And the alley got down to about 59 to 60. I checked in the morning. So 57 was your low at Farmingdale, 57 at Islip and West Hampton. There you go, 48 degrees for your low at West Hampton. That is pretty low right there. That's the radiational cooling. That's the magic of radiational cooling that you get in the West Hampton area of the Pine Barrens. In the city, low is 59 in Central Park. See, just like Central Park, it's what my alley is. Let's see what we have here. 54 for a low in Toms River, 54 at Lakehurst. 50. So generally around 50. Unfortunately, we don't have Miller Air Park. It's not working. Or is it working again? Now, this one is Berkeley Township, 52 degrees for your low. So, not quite as cool as West Hampton, but still a pretty cool night, which is nice to see. And we haven't had weather like this in a while, this comfortable weather. And you can see on Long Island, highs generally in the mid-70s. 75 for a high at Farmingdale, 75 at Islip, 74 at West Hampton, 72 at Central Park, early enough, a little cooler there. 76 at LaGuardia, 77 at JFK. And let's see what it was in New Jersey. Probably a little warmer. Let's 76, look pretty similar today. 75, 74 in Lakehurst, 77. So, yeah, pretty similar highs in Jersey were maybe just a touch warmer than Long Island, but just by a couple of degrees because of the cloud cover, I guess. So let's go now look at some other information here we have. Close this down here. We'll get to that in a minute. We're going to go through some of these storm reports again and the rainfall reports from Ida. It's just amazing how Ida just held together. And we can't even go through all of these. We're going to go through just some of them here because there's just so many. I'll just scroll through. Flash flooding on the Bronx River Parkway, flash flooding Essex County, Branchbrook Park, flooding, and a lot of the Hardscrabble Road in Port Jervis close to flooding. I'm just going to scroll through these. Richmond and Staten Island, a flash flood in Annandale. I mean, there's so many floods here. Victory Boulevard closed to flooding. Flooding on the Cross River Parkway in Yonkers. You know, Westchester got hit very hard by this flooding. A flash flood in Newark Airport. All lanes closed on North Avenue at Kapowski Road. I mean, there's flash flooding everywhere. A lot of water rescues. Thousands of cars destroyed. All these flash flooded in Millburn. Flash floods in Paramus, Westchester. Kearney Post Office. The roof collapsed. That's incredible. Thunderstorm wind damage in Bergen County. Tree into a house. So we had the wind damage, too. We've had fires, too, going on, too. Some houses have fire. Mansville has had fires. I've heard about that, too. Multiple roads throughout town in Kearney closed due to flooding. Numerous water rescues going on in Livingston. Rescue boat is pulling occupants to safety. It's just an example of what all hell that broke loose the other night. Multiple cars underwater. Significant flooding on so many different roadways here. It is a basement apartments. Unfortunately, people got trapped. This is why basement apartments generally aren't legal, because exactly for that reason, you cannot get out in case in a flood. And so, unfortunately, people died because of that. You know, some people's cars were swept away by these rivers. So water spilling at the home through doors, Crown Heights. You can see most of these reports are not on Long Island, but there are a few of them here. Eaton's Neck, trees down. Flash flood in Eaton's Neck, basement flooded. I'm trying to look to show you some Long Island ones here. I know we had some trees into houses. So this just gives you an example of what I went through a lot of these already, but I'll provide the links for you below. And again, we'll look at the total rainfall reports. Again, just go over these really quickly here. Some of these are just incredible. Stamford, 8.10 inches. I mean, it's just incredible rainfall amounts. This is Connecticut. So Connecticut got hammered, too. I mean, you got, 8 inches, 9 inches of rain in some areas. Look at Madison, 8.90 inches. New London County. Even Connecticut had to deal with this flooding. Bergen County, almost 9 inches in North Arlington. That's insane. Essex County, Maplewood, 8.39. I mean, Harrison, 8.72. Passaic County, 8.43. Union County, Cranford, reporting 9.05 inches. That is incredible amounts of rain there. And we have some new reports here on Long Island, too. Glen Cove, 9.09 inches. And the Glen Cove High School, I believe, is going to be closed. They're not going to be able to open the schools because there's flood damage. And they're trying to clean that up. In Manhattan, Matthew Palmer Playground, 9.55 inches of rain. Orange County, Stewart Airport, 7.32. I can't read through all these. You can always pause the video. Mayo Pack in Putnam County, 7.28. 6.90 in Flushing, Queens. Staten Island, 8.92. Suffolk County, Oldfield got 7.20. Easetalk at 6.86. You get the idea. These rainfall totals are just incredible. And again, the link will be in the description below if you want to read through that. Ida is just a historic storm causing damage all the way from, New York City wound up getting more rain than New Orleans, believe it or not. I just want to read over this, that they are restoring power in the South, in New Orleans, in Louisiana. You could see that they've reduced the outage number. New Orleans, they've reduced it slightly. Still a lot of outages, though. Catastrophic damage to their transmission lines. And right now, of the 222 affected substations, 99 have returned to service as of 8 a.m., as well as 79 of the 209 affected transmission lines. But more than 1,350 miles of transmission lines remain out of service. And they were able to bring back power to New Orleans through the east. I don't know if they've gotten it back through the west yet, but they certainly have from the east. I'm going to talk a little more about this power restoration in New Orleans in another video. This is pretty much what the outage map looks like in New Orleans. And you can see pockets mainly on the east side, but some on the west side too, starting to get power. And it looks like the French Quarter might have power again too. So that's important. So speaking of hurricanes, let's talk about Larry. Larry is strengthening, so let's get to this. And this is the track from the Hurricane Center. Bermuda may have to worry about this, but right now it still tracks offshore for us. Let's read the latest public advisory right now on Larry. Larry intensifies into a Category 2 hurricane as of 5 p.m., location 15.0 north, 42.0 west, about 1,175 miles west of the southernmost Cabo Verde Islands and about 1,320 miles east of the Leeward Islands. Maximum sustained winds 100 miles an hour, moving west-northwest at 16 miles an hour. Minimum sensor pressure 978 millibars, 29.88 inches. And the hurricane force winds extend out up to 35 miles from the center, and tropical storm force winds extend outward up to 150 miles from the center. This is a pretty powerful hurricane. And fortunately, it should track away from us, but this is as far as their map goes. It's way out there, all right? It's way out there, but look at this thing. There it is. Look at that. That is a very healthy-looking hurricane right there, and it's going to continue to strengthen, and this is going to become a major hurricane. Could be Category 4 or better, maybe even a Category 5. It's got nothing in the way, nothing in the way to keep this thing from continuing to intensify. And if we look at the models, the spaghetti models, you'll see they all recurve it, fortunately. So they all recurve it. They keep it out in the middle of the ocean. Maybe we'd even miss Bermuda at this point. Hopefully it doesn't hit anyone because you definitely don't want that. And looking at these models, you could see some of them even take it up to a Category 5. Wow, that is pretty bad. This is definitely a storm that's going to have to be watched. We'll have to see what happens with this. Let's see if we can get a satellite image of this. It should have Larry here, so you can get an idea of the visible satellite. Here you go. Here's the visible satellite of Larry. Look at that. That's impressive right there. That's definitely an impressive-looking hurricane. But fortunately, it's in the middle of the ocean, and hopefully that's where it stays. We can also look at past storms and look at Ida, actually. Now, let's see if we can look up past 2021 Atlantic storms. Let's see if we can get to Ida here. Let's see. You might be able to track this. Let's see if it... I guess it doesn't. I was wondering if it had like a loop of the whole thing. I guess not. Maybe there is a way to get it, but... You know, you've seen it already. It's out of our lives, but the damage remains. And it's going to take months, maybe years, to clean up in some of these towns that were hit very hard by Ida. Let's go look at the models, and we'll start with the... let's go to the North American view here, we'll go and we'll look at the wind, and you'll see that we do have a jet stream, and that's why we have better weather coming in, and that jet stream is going to stay with us, which is very important. This is Larry right here. So I'm showing you this to show you that there's a trough in the jet stream that picks it up and pushes it out. And that's important that we have these troughs coming through that help push these storms out. If we didn't have them, you know what happens when we don't have them. And we had to worry about that with Henry, or Henry, I should say. Let's now go to the CONUS view, and we will go and look at the surface features and show you what's going to be happening here. So got this high pressure. It stays over us for one more day, and then it starts moving offshore Sunday, bringing the return of some humidity and a chance of some showers, nothing major. Another front moves through on Labor Day. Another high builds in. So we have a progressive pattern. Another front approaches Wednesday night, moves offshore. That's the front that's going to kick Larry away, all right? And then we have another nice high pressure moving in for Friday and the weekend after that. So you can see progressive pattern. This is the kind of pattern we want to see. Fronts moving through, troughs coming through. This is the pattern that's what we are supposed to have, especially as we head into September. So let's go look take a closer look at our aerial. Let's look at the HRRR 0Z run, and we will go and look and show you that tomorrow we're not going to have any precipitation, so we're all clear tomorrow. It's Sunday that we'll have that chance of some light showers in the afternoon, and I mean light. It's not going to be anything heavy. All right. Showing you the dew points, dry air stays for tomorrow. We start with north winds becoming west and then south later on. And that's going to bring in some more increases in the humidity by evening, but nothing terrible. But you'll be feeling a little more humidity on Sunday with the south wind. All right. Looking at our high temperatures, Sunday with the clouds around, it will stay cool. And tomorrow, it only has us, I mean, maybe it's a touch warmer than tomorrow, maybe mid to upper 70s, but probably most areas aren't going to see 80 degrees. All right, the HRRR might be a little low. We will go ahead and look at the GFS, but generally, it's going to be comfortable tomorrow and comfortable Sunday. And then Monday, it'll be a little warmer. And then Tuesday, you see, we get a little more of a warmer flow here. At the end of the week, we're going to start to see some 80s until the next cold front moves through on Thursday and Friday, and then it'll knock us back down to the 70s again. Let's look at the dew points here, and we'll show you again. The dew points stay low tomorrow, but then they start rising for Sunday. And Monday, you see that westerly flow. So it'll be more of a westerly flow. This won't be as cool as the air that we had, but it'll still be fair weather. And then Wednesday it looks like a humid day. And that would be probably our next strong cold front to come through. And then Thursday, we'll start pushing this front offshore and seeing the drier air move in by Friday. Let's now look at the skies. You'll see here that we'll first start with the GFS, which overdoes the clouds, of course. I think it'll be maybe a few high clouds around tomorrow, but I think there'll be plenty of sunshine. Sunday, we'll see more in the way of cloudiness. Monday, we'll start with cloudiness, then breaks the sun. And then Tuesday should be fairly sunny and, you know, a little warmer, obviously, feeling a little more like summer, but still not a bad day. Wednesday, probably not a bad day either. But then as we get to later into Wednesday night and Thursday, that's when we have this front. And we have to watch out with that. There is, it's coming close enough. Larry's coming close enough that it could kick up the surf. Just keep an eye on that. And then by Friday, we have more clear weather again. And then a nice weekend for next weekend. Let's look at the NAM. Look at a few more models for the sky, I guess. I'll have to use the 18Z. So you see some clouds around tomorrow, but like I said, I think New Jersey might see more, but I think it'll be a pretty sunny day. But Sunday, we're definitely going to be seeing more of those clouds. Let's go look at the RGM. So here's the RGM model, and you'll see some of those cirrus clouds. And more of them, they're going to be more likely be over New Jersey. For the most part, though, we're going to have fairly clear skies. Tomorrow should be a nice day. So third nice day in a row, and then we start seeing those clouds for Sunday. But then look at that. Later on Monday, we clear it out again. So your Labor Day looks very nice as well. So let's lastly just look at the HRRR smoke model, which I know we haven't done. Oh, that's the wrong one. My mistake. That is something else entirely. Let's go look at the vertically integrated smoke loop and just show you that I think we're going to continue to have clean air over our area. Now, let's see. Well, the smoke looks like it might be heading toward us, so I'll have to see. As we get toward the 5th, we may be dealing with a little bit of it. The 5th, so Sunday into Monday. Monday, we may be dealing with a little bit of the smoke. Before this front comes through, you can see this front right here, and it'll push it out of the way again. We may be dealing just a little bit of smoke, all right? These fires are still going out west, you know. I mean, we'll look at it on the, they've been having a little more control over them, but what they really need is rain. That's what they need. And the problem is, if we go to the tropical tidbits and we look at the, precipitation. Let's see if any rain is going to finally fall out west on the total accumulated precip model here. And I'm going to run this. You can see it looks like it does have more rain in the forecast for the east. And it's getting closer, though. It looks like there is the rain is getting closer to California. So hopefully they'll start seeing some beneficial rains into California. The other thing to note on here. And we should note this too, is this another tropical system. This one might impact Baja California here. And I'm wondering if that has a name. If that's a Pacific storm that's already been named or not. Let's see. We'd have to go to the Hurricane Center and look and see. So this is the Eastern Pacific. There is nothing right now, but the model does seem to want to develop something. But there is Larry, and again, we're going to have to watch Larry. It's going to continue to intensify into a major hurricane. It's going to become a major hurricane. Just to give you an example of how major it will be, let's see what it looks like on windy.com here. Let's see. There it is right there, right? So this is the European model here. So we can show you, track it along here. You can see how it's strengthening. You see that white around the eye? That's when you see that, you know, you're dealing with a Category 4, perhaps a Category 5 storm here. This is the European. This is the sustained winds. And we go to gusts here, which, there you go. Look at that. That you're dealing with a Category 4 or Category 5 hurricane there when you see that. And let's see what the European does. It does continue to track it northwest. And this could hit Bermuda again. So the European seems to have it coming very close to Bermuda. This is Thursday. And then it recurves it. There's the trough. It hits the trough, unfortunately recurves it. But it could hit Bermuda as a Category 4 or 5, perhaps. All right. If we look at the GFS, GFS takes it a little farther east and is a little faster with this as well. They all recurve it, though, and I think the icon does as well. Well, that's as far as the icon goes. But, again, this is going to be a major hurricane, and let's hope it stays away from Bermuda. Bermuda, though, is a very fortified place. They somehow deal with these hurricanes, and they have their infrastructure is solid. It's amazing how they can take these hurricanes fairly well. But they are in the middle of Hurricane Alley. But let's just hope it stays away from land. You don't even want Bermuda to get hit. Let's just hope it makes that curve and stays out in the ocean where it belongs. That's going to wrap up this weather update. Take care, and thanks for watching.